Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Russ Courtnall Be a Pro series here in NHL 16 on the Xbox One. Russ Courtnall with the Arizona Coyotes been drafted there and trying to make the club in preseason here. Stick around for when the regular season starts. There are three preseason games left, starting with this game against the LA Kings. Home game here for the Coyotes, so let's get ready to get this thing going here. You see Lindback in net for the Coyotes and for the Kings, Jonathan Quick, of course. However, it is preseason, so it could have been just about anybody in net there. But they'll go with their starter, Jonathan Quick, one of the more consistent goaltenders in the NHL. You see the Coyotes kind of swarming the zone right here in the first, and Quick is going to cover up. No goal there, but Arizona is going to get one in the first period. As a matter of fact, they're going to get two in the first period, take a 2-0 lead, and we continue on play there. That's intercepted by Courtnall. Get that up to a teammate, and he's got a partial break. Can he put it in the net? No, he misses. Courtnall gets it back to him in front, and another save by Quick. Great opportunities there, but they do not get the third goal of the game. Another rush here, passing back and forth. Courtnall headed to the net, and the puck never exactly gets on his stick. I think Quick got a piece of that as it was coming across the crease. Courtnall has been kept off the score sheet so far in this one, but he's getting a pass at center ice here, coming on in by himself. Nice little move to the inside, but that is another stop by Quick on the backhander. Quick is ready for the task. Shot was really pretty much right at him here, but you'll see Courtnall making a little move here, trying to get around the defender. Does get his backhand off. Nice little quick deke right there, but Quick is ready for it. So we go further into the game now, and it's another goal while he's sitting on the bench. It's 3-0. Let's go Coyotes here. End of a shift. They see calling for him to go to the bench, but he takes a quick shot there. And Quick has a blocker save right there. Goes back to the bench. We got a 3-2 game now as this thing goes down to the wire, and it is over. The Coyotes get another preseason victory. Nothing on the score sheet for Russ Courtnall here, but they do get the win, and that feels good, of course. It'll feel even better, of course, if they can carry over some of these wins to the regular season and have a successful time there. That's what's really going to count. Okay, they're sticking with what worked. That means he's staying on the third line. All right, well, at least he hasn't been bumped to the fourth line. So it's a new week, and we have a chance to roll out our player training here. Going to go with passing since we are a playmaker. Want to make sure that's up to snuff there, as well as the defensive positioning, because that is the spot that we struggle with the most, getting our grades up, so definitely want to work on the defense on those attributes there as much as we can off the ice. So here we go, a game against Calgary, and they strike really early, making this 1-0. Let's see if the Coyotes can respond. Big hit in the corner, turning the puck over. Okay, here comes Arizona out of their end. This puck is to Courtnall, crossing the blue line. He stops. He looks to pass, and he gets it blocked, but then he puts it on net, and it goes. The wrist shot gets past the goaltender, tying this up at 1-1. Jonas Hiller could not make the save. Let's see what happened here. Honestly, I was trying to hit the pass button. I was trying to get this across ice here to a teammate who may or may not have even been there. It was blocked, deflected by the defender, right back on his tape. And he beats Hiller stick side, making it 1-1. So a little bit of a good play there to stick with it, but a little bit of luck as well to find the net. So it's 1-1, and speaking of going right to the net, that is kind of a soft goal right there. But Calgary does take the 2-1 lead. That's a little frustrating there. Cover up the puck. Anyway, here they come again. Second period, and oh, there you go, right in front. Puts it home, and it's 3-1 Calgary. And a little bit of sloppy play right now by the Coyotes. They got to pick it up here in the second period. So here we go, breaking out of the zone. Courtnall trying to get involved in this play, breaking towards the net. Rebound! It's in the net! It's in the net, but hold on, they say no goal. Did Courtnall kick it in? What happened here? Let's see the shot. Nice, juicy rebound right there. Tries to get a whack at it with his stick, but I think it goes in off his skate. This is why they call it no goal. However, was it a kicking motion or was it just a deflection off his skate? What will they rule? They go to the replay, and when they come back here, they're going to say Good goal. There you go. It's Courtnell's second goal of the game. Yeah. Talk about being in the right place at the right time and having a little luck. There it was again as it goes in off his skate, but it counts. Calgary up 3-2. Courtnell awaiting his next shift, and here he goes. He's on the ice. He's got to get back in the play here as Calgary has the puck. Nope, now it's turned over. Here come the Coyotes out of their zone. Courtnell is going to get the puck, crossing the line. Pass to a teammate, gets it back. Nope, deflected there, but behind. Bumps a Flame player off the puck. Goes to the net, and it's in! What? He was just trying to drive to the front of the net, get a pass to a teammate. It somehow ends up in the net, and he's got a hat trick. Holy smokes, he's got three, well, what I would call somewhat lucky goals here, and he's got a hat trick. But a nice play, good effort, and when you drive the net, sometimes good things happen, and that's really been the point here, especially the last two goals, really all three. This was meant to just get it in front, shovel it in front, and whatever happened, it's almost like a bit of a wraparound there, and he beats the goaltender, so he's got all three Arizona goals right now, third period. And he goes to the bench right here, and as he does, his teammates put the puck in the net, and it's 4-3. There you go. Once down 3-1 in this game, Arizona storms back and takes a lead. Coyotes have the momentum on their side as this third period opens. Ekman-Larsson gets the goal from the D spot there, and they have the lead. But hold on a second. Smith has problems with that one, and that's shoveled in the net. Once again, not being able to control a rebound really kills him there. We got a 4-4 hockey game. I don't think Mike Smith's too happy with his play right now. This game is going to overtime. We got 3-on-3 rules this year. This should be interesting. Got to be careful here. Ekman-Larsson gets the block, but he's injured. We go the other way, and it's Courtnell. He's going to rag this puck a little bit, waiting for a teammate, trying to set something up. 3-on-3, and it gets this on net. Oh, speaking of rebounds, Hiller does not give one right there. He hangs onto the puck. But you've got Ekman-Larsson headed to the locker room here with probably a bruised foot. That can't feel real good. So we continue with overtime. Get this puck out to Courtnell. He's breaking out 1-on-2. So once again, going to rag this puck. Wait for a teammate. Try to make a move to the net. The pass. Oh, a great setup there. But Hiller makes the save, thwarting a game-winning opportunity. Oh, puck turned over. Courtnell gets it. Good job, but he's again 1-on-2. He's going to let it go, but another save by Hiller. We're in the waning seconds of overtime here, facing a shootout coming right up here as this time ticks off, and there you go. We are officially going to the shootout. Shane Doan going to be the first shooter for the Coyotes, and he's going to put it in the net. His teammates approve right there on the bench, as you see. Let's look at the replay as Doan gets the scoring started in the shootout. The Flames have a chance to answer here. They missed their first attempt, but the second round coming up right here, and they will also get a goal, knotting this thing up at one apiece now. Watch the move right here. Backhand, forehand quickly, and wraps it around Mike Smith. So here we go. Russ Courtnell is the second shooter for the Coyotes. I'm not known for my shootout skills, but let's try to go. Backhand, no. Okay, that wasn't nearly fast enough or deceptive enough. And Hiller makes the save right there. So we remain one apiece. But last shooter for Arizona could win it, and he does. Backhand, not even sure who that was, but he gets the goal, and Arizona wins. Again, just a preseason game, but they got things going pretty well here in the preseason, hopefully giving them some momentum going in to regular season play. So there you go, a hat trick for young Russ Courtnell, and a salute to the fans by the Coyotes. Nice touch right there. Three stars, your number one star, Russ Courtnell, with three goals and two hits out there. Ekman-Larsson, before injuring himself, has a goal and assist. Sticking with him on the third line, huh? I would have thought maybe I'd get bumped back up to the second after having a hat trick. Yeah, guess not. Anyway, the grading is getting better there for him, bringing that defense grade up with some blocked shots and some better positioning. They're in Vancouver tonight to finish off the preseason here against Ryan Miller and company, who has not lost. But then again, it's preseason, so who really cares? You got Lesio breaking out 2-on-2 with Courtnell. Back to Lesio, and a goal! There's an assist for Courtnell, setting up his teammate. And we've got the first marker of the game in the first period, beating Ryan Miller. Let's look at it again here as Lucas Alessio lights the lamp with a helper from Courtnall. Nice pass right there. He puts it on net accurately and has himself a goal. The last game out for Courtnall was all about putting it in the net. He had the hat trick, but today he's trying to set up some teammates here. As here he's set up by the faceoff, and a shot right off of it is stopped by Miller. But Courtnall being aggressive right there, putting it on net. He learned last game how valuable that can be, because you just never know. But there you go. Miller is able to see this shot and make the save. So it remains 1-0 late in the first period. How about the very next faceoff? That's going to be one. Lucas Alessio with control of the puck. He is going to get that to Vermette. Vermette to Courtnall, setting him up in a good spot. But again, Miller makes the save. So good work getting in position for open shots. But Courtnall is denied again. You see the replay. Nice little spot to receive a pass. And he's able to get it on that. But it's not going to go. So 1-1 right now, midway through the second period and midway through the game. Alessio is going to dump that deep into the Canucks zone. Coyotes fighting for it there. They keep it alive for a bit. Oh, a nice chance right there, but he stopped. Alessio again, and he scores. Great determination right there. And Lucas Lesio's got his second of the hockey game. Somewhere in this mess, Courtnall's going to end up with the second helper. I don't know if it was a pass quite early on there, but they kept it in the zone, and he gets it done, and the Coyotes get it done as well, getting the close victory in this game and ending up the preseason with quite a run here. So the spotlight is on you now. Welcome to the Arizona Coyotes. We've given you a nameplate for your locker, but remember, play poorly and there's a place for you in the minors, so keep up the good work. All right, we made the team out of training camp and out of preseason. So what this means is Russ Courtnall set for his NHL debut against the LA Kings coming up. He couldn't be more excited. Can't wait to get this thing going for real with Russ Courtnall. Join me next time. We'll see you then.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!